Welcome back, everybody. I'm CeramicWeasel, and I am still here in the Pridwin. I am just going to get straight
Nothing
back
to
into
report
it.
Right
and,
now, Knight.
Yeah, thanks a lot. I'm just going to get straight back into the game and continue where I left off trying to complete this quest. What was it? Support the recon team. No, I'm not going to do that. This one, report to Paladin Danse. Yes.
Paladin Danse.
There you are. How did it go with Elder Maxon?
Oh. Yes. oh, jeez.
Maxon seems so young compared to everyone else. You're okay with that?
Don't let his age fool you. Maxon's a brilliant tactician, a formidable warrior, and possesses an idealistic vision for the future of the Brotherhood. I'd follow him anywhere, without question.
Oh, good to know. Alright. I guess he's very dedicated. I'd like to say he's delusional, but that would be impolite. Maybe I should say he's delusional. Let's see what happens when I say he's delusional.
He sounds pretty delusional to me. You don't actually buy everything he's saying, do you?
You shouldn't judge Maxon on his words alone. His actions prove his sincerity. I just hope you appreciate how much of a chance I'm taking bringing you into the fold this quickly. Not to put too fine a point on it, but if you screw up, we go down together.
Oh, yeah, I'm sorry to hear that, man. I guess I'll be careful then.
Don't worry, I'll be careful.
Good, because we've got a lot of work ahead of us, and I don't want anything slowing us down. Now, I know you're eager to hop into a suit of power armor and take the fight to the Institute. But first things first. In order to be an effective part of the team, you need to learn your way around this ship and get to know its crew. Since I've been officially assigned to you as your sponsor, I'd recommend taking me along with you.
Okay. I guess.
Sounds good. Let's go.
Outstanding.
Okay. So that means Piper leaves. All right. Then that's fine. Yeah. All right. She can go back to Diamond City. I didn't need her anyway. Damn it.
I heard that Elder Maxon got that scar on his face from going one-on-one with a Deathclaw.
Nice.
Greetings, Knight.
Greetings. Yeah, so I started to walk around the ship and loot some stuff, but people started talking to me and saying interesting things, so I thought I would stop and actually do the rest of this stuff in the Let's Play. So let's just get on with, I believe we're supposed to go talk to these people, yes.
Ah, good. You're finally here. Just set the books down anywhere. I'll get to them as soon as I can.
Yes.
What, not even a thank you?
I hardly need to... Oh my, it appears I've mistaken you for someone else. Since it's obvious that you aren't who I was expecting, would you mind telling me why you're here?
Oh, I'd like to ask the same question. Yeah.
I'm asking myself the same thing.
I don't recognize you, which leads me to the conclusion that you're a new recruit. Specifically, the one that Paladin Danse described in his report. Under normal circumstances, I'd provide you with a proper orientation of my department. However, I'm woefully behind setting up research patrols and getting bombarded with requests for technical documentation. Unfortunately, I'm lacking the personnel needed to get the job done.
Oh, hint, 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 hint. Oh, fine. Yeah, let's just...
Maybe I can lend you a hand.
That would be splendid. As you patrol the Commonwealth, keep your eyes open for blueprints, memos, manuals, books, charts. Anything containing useful technical data. I'm authorized to pay you for each bundle of documents that you recover. And if you wish to be assigned to a research patrol, I have plenty of them waiting to be filled. In any event, it was a pleasure to meet you, Knight.
Yeah, sure. Pleasure to meet you too. So yes, that all these quests are just going to pile up as I talk to these people, I'm sure, but we are just going to power
Glad
through.
Glad you finally stopped by, soldier. Are you ready for your medical exam?
Sarcastic? I wish... Clearly, this dialogue mod is not working properly. It is not telling me what different options say, I might have to replace it, because that is the entire reason that I got this thing. But we'll go with it.
As long as it doesn't involve petroleum jelly and rubber gloves, I'm ready.
No. This isn't that sort of examination. I'm going to ask you a series of medical-related questions, and I'd like you to answer me to the best of your ability. First question. As a child, were you ever exposed to radiation for an extended period of time?
As a child, was I ever exposed to radiation? I don't think so. Maybe this one.
Wouldn't Vault-Tec's screening process have caught this already?
Vault-Tec's screening process? Let me check my notes here. You were a vault dweller? You're probably healthier than anyone else aboard. Anyway, sorry I missed that in your records. Just going down the list of questions. I'm sure you understand.
Oh, of course.
Okay, second question. Have you ever had or come in contact with a person confirmed to be carrying a communicable disease?
Confirmed? I don't really remember, actually.
Honestly, I don't remember.
Well, you don't appear to be suffering from any long-term ill effects, so I'll assume you haven't. Third question, and please answer honestly. Have you ever had sexual relations with any species considered non-human?
What species are there that are considered non-human? Oh, geez.
That happens often enough for you to have a question about it?
You'd be surprised how many wastelanders answer yes to that question. Fortunately, the Brotherhood finds that type of behavior absolutely distasteful. Since you haven't spent too much time in the wasteland, I'll assume your last question.
Okay.
Would you have any problems pulling the trigger on an enemy of the Brotherhood, whether they're human, formerly human, or machine?
Let's go with this.
If my life's in danger, I'll do whatever it takes to defend myself.
That's an acceptable answer, and the most common. Excellent. I think I've got all the information I need. I see no reason to prevent you from beginning your duties immediately. If you ever need medical assistance, you let me know.
Thanks, buddy. I accidentally skipped through one of the conversation options there. I'm not going to go back and redo it or anything because, you could read the you can read the subtitles.
Why are you bothering with that junk?
Hey, this is expensive junk. You can go read the subtitles if you really want to know what he was about to say, and it's not that important, so we're just going to carry on. Why can I not pick up this rad X? There we go. I don't know.
Please state the nature of your medical emergency.
I don't have a medical emergency. I'm just looting you of all your possessions. Because clearly I need them more than you do. Great Mentats. Nice. Holotape night cage report. I guess we can listen to that.
Medical report, Knight Captain Cage reported. I've been working closely with Scribe Naraya examining some of the synth bodies that our recon teams have recovered.
Ooh.
Even though we have yet to recover the synth that appear completely human, these lesser models are still astoundingly advanced. What's becoming apparent is that the Institute is the most technologically gifted enemy we've ever encountered, and therefore exceedingly dangerous. I've turned over all of my data to Lancer Captain Kells, along with my recommendations for developing effective countermeasures for these synths. Unfortunately, I'm not sure how much it will help, given the fact that the real enemy are the synths that could be hiding among us.
Yes. Well, that's not as interesting as I was hoping. It seems like he's only examined like Gen 1 and 2 synths, which is not very interesting. They're just robots. Come on. I wanted to hear his opinion about the other synths, but oh well. That's a shame. I think we're just gonna sort of like push forward and try and get through this relatively quickly. I just want to make sure that I'm not missing anything important. It doesn't look like it. I may have already been through here, actually.
So, you're the new recruit I heard about. Not what I was expecting.
Really? What were you expecting? Or maybe, no, this one.
What were you expecting?
The last batch of recruits we took on were wastelanders. Dirty, beaten up, looking for a handout. They were desperate and looking for an easy out. You look like you're here for a reason. Anyway, since you came down here to meet me, we may as well get it over with. My name's Ingram, and this lovely little grease pit is where you'll usually find me. If your power armor's too tight in the crotch, the Pridwin's about to crash into the ground, or a robot's gone haywire, you come see me.
Okay, I'll try to remember that the next time a robot goes haywire. Sarcasm. Let's try it.
While you're at it, my car is making this weird grinding noise when I back it out of the driveway.
You're gonna have to take a number. There isn't a day that goes by on this tub without five or six things breaking down. And since I'm stuck in this rig, I'm not quite as spry as I used to be. The work tends to pile up.
Yeah, I'm sure. Oh, right, yes. Missing legs.
You feel like telling me how you ended up that way?
That's a little personal, don't you think?
Yeah, you're right, probably.
Come on. If we're going to be working as a team, we should get to know each other better.
I guess I can't argue with that.
No, you can't.
I was fighting with the Brotherhood in the Capital Wasteland. Worked at a staging area for the Power Armor troops. Our position was along a ridge line overlooking the battlefield. I'd say it was a 100-foot drop, give or take.
You weren't aboard the Pridwin?
The Pridwin wasn't under Maxon's command at the time. It wasn't even in the Capital Wasteland. If she'd had been there, the battle wouldn't have been such a challenge. To make a long story short, the ridge I was standing on took a hit from a nuke. Sheared most of the cliff right off, and caused the platform I was standing on to tumble over the side. If I hadn't been test piloting one of the power armor suits at the time, I would have died.
Wait, you were in power armor?
Your power armor helped you survive the fall?
Yeah, it took the brunt of the impact. But I don't know if I'd call it surviving. The suit was trashed after it landed, and I lost both of my legs. Haven't walked since. Anyway, I'm sure you're here to get your hands on some power armor. There's a pretty decent T-60 suit sitting in Bay 3 that's all yours. The left leg actuator's a bit sticky, but it'll keep the creeps off of you. Oh, and if you need any work done on it, feel free to use the workshops around here. Now, if you'll excuse me, I need to get back to work.
Alright, cool. But yeah, I'm surprised. I thought power armor was supposed to allow you to jump from any height without taking any damage, or at least that's the way it works for me. I think you have a good case to sue Bethesda for damages and medical bills there, because clearly that was a bug in the game that caused you to take that injury. Oh, shut up, Dance. I don't want to hear it. Okay, so yes, I do want to get into that power armor, and that's going to be all fun and extremely exciting, but we have somebody else we need to talk to first, so let's just get on with this and...
Step forward, Knight. Even though they've locked me in this blasted cage, I promise that I won't bite.
Ooh, okay. Yeah.
Looks uncomfortable in there.
It's not that bad. Now, this is the stowage depot, and I, as you probably already guessed, am the ship's quartermaster. Proctor Tegan. The powers that be have me locked in here, so I can keep an eye on the Brotherhood's valuables. If you need to stock up on supplies before you head out on a mission, this is the place to buy them.
Okay, I have... Wait.
Wait, buy them? Since when does the military sell equipment to its own soldiers?
Since someone dropped a whole bunch of bombs and blew up every single factory that manufactured weapons and ammunition. Keeping the Brotherhood supplied takes caps, and everyone contributes to the cause. The good news is by having a constant flow of caps, I'm able to buy whatever you bring me.
Oh, I suppose that
I'm
is
I'm mostly
good news.
Interested in weapons, but I'll take anything useful. Of course, if you're just looking to make a few caps on the side, I might have some extra work for you to do.
Oh, no. I don't have time for that.
Caps on the side, huh? Doesn't sound like official military business to me.
Well, it is, and it isn't. It's complicated. It just involves a little bit of heavy lifting and interacting with the local fauna. And since I'm stuck up here manning this one-man zoo, I need someone to do the legwork for me. After you're done with the meet and greet, we can discuss the details. In the meantime, if you ever need anything else, a gun, a mod, even ammo, you just let me know.
Okay, will do, man. Yeah, all right. I don't have the time to hang around and talk to you too much, because I believe I am going to be sent on a mission very, very shortly, and this will take priority, I think, over everything else. And then, you know, I'll probably bugger off and do my own thing. So I'm supposed to go meet with Elder Maxon, which would be a good time to get into my power armor, I guess.
We'll stop the Institute for Maxon and for the Brotherhood.
I wonder if I can upgrade this stuff. Do I have the supplies to upgrade some of this stuff? It's already Model B. Yeah, I don't have... Doesn't look like I have the perks to do it anyway, and I probably don't have the equipment either, because it probably takes like a stack of aluminum, to say it like an American, and other things. So we'll make do with this. I'm sure it'll be fine. Oh, but I also need to sleep. Oh, dance like that. Okay, cool.
Despair, brother. We're here to save the Commonwealth.
Yeah, I'm sure you are, man. Don't worry. I will do it. I will do it for you. You don't have to do a thing. Just stay where you are, and let me handle it. Okay, so this is my storage. So this is probably my bed. Let's just do that then, huh? All right. 8 hours, I think, because I am tired. So yeah. Last time I was criticizing the Brotherhood of Steel a little bit and sort of talking about how I don't like them, and, you know, they have their good sides, I guess. They're not all bad, but there are things that sort of aggravate me about them, and I suppose it's...
That's all isn't bad. Well, as long as you don't smell it before you eat it.
Okay. I suppose it has a lot to do with specifically Elder Maxon and his attitudes towards everything. He doesn't seem to be particularly friendly guy or all that concerned about his fellow troops and the safety of the people who serve under him. And you know, he has some pretty radical ideas about you know, what he considers to be, I guess they're not really radical, but I mean, he's very sort of like anti-AI, anti-mutant, anti-ghoul, with, what? Okay, with like no room for nuance or anything. So, he will not make exceptions.
You haven't lived until you tipped a Brahmin with a Vertibird. Now that's a challenge.
You... what? Huh? No! Damn it! Leave those Brahmin alone! And this is another reason I don't like these guys. They're total jocks and act like big jerks to everybody, but particularly Brahmin. I should destroy them for the sake of Brahmin everywhere, but I won't do that. So where is Elder Maxon? He's over here. Okay. Okay, come on.
Now that you've familiarized yourself with the Pridwin's crew, are you ready for your next assignment, brother?
Yes. Let's go.
Yes, Elder.
Good. Let's get right to it, then. Shall we? Take a look over there. That's Fort Strong. And it's infested with super mutants.
Uh-huh.
Having those aberrations of nature close enough to smell is making me sick to my stomach. To make matters worse, they're sitting on top of a massive stockpile of Fat Man shells we could use in our campaign.
Oh, I'm sure you could.
I want you to head over there, wipe out everything that moves, and secure that stockpile. Understood?
Yeah, alright, cool.
Consider it done.
Look, I realize you're eager to take the fight to the Institute, but it'll have to wait. The Brotherhood cannot allow those abominations to have a nuclear arsenal at their fingertips.
It'll be a pleasure to exterminate that mutant filth.
Now,
wow.
We have a Vertibird on standby, fully armed and ready to depart. Use it to carry our message to Fort Strong and wipe those dirty mutants from the face of the earth. Dismissed.
Wow, they really rub it in thick, don't they? It's just like very sort of, yeah, it's very over the top of expressing their distaste for everything that's going on. But all right, yeah. So do we have to go to the airport first? Is that what we have to do? Board the Vertibird gunship, right? Is it this one or is it that one? No, it's this one. Definitely this one. I was not aware. I thought we could go straight to Fort Strong. Is that not a thing? Where is the Vertibird that I'm supposed to board then?
Remember your three C's.
Is it not here? Oh, did they move it? What's going on? Let's get rid of these things. Show no mercy. Wait, it's up there? I am confused. I thought I boarded the Vertibird. Oh, I know what happens. Yeah, okay. I had the quest markers on for the other quests that I've got. They were pointing me to the Vertibird that takes me down to the airport, whereas I should have gotten on to the other Vertibird, I'm sure, right? Is that... Yeah, okay, there it is. There it is. Good to know. No! We left Paladin Danse behind! You monster! Oh, it's okay. We can get by without him. We've got this. Let's move. And I will resist temptation to shoot the soldiers. Oh, jeez. Okay. So, yeah, basically, there's good reason for me to be doing this, even though I do not intend to follow the Brotherhood of Steel questline too much. There are gains to be had with
I'll try and keep them in your sights.
Oh, what? Huh? What am I keeping in my sights? Yeah, yeah. So there are gains to be had by allying yourself with the Brotherhood of Steel so that you can get access to Vertibird support, and this will allow you to move around the map a lot easier. Where are all these mutants? There they are. Okay. Alright. Just trying to figure out where the one shooting me were. But I don't want to kill that guy too quickly because... As soon as he dies, I think the Vertibird lands. And I kind of want to stay in the Vertibird for as long as possible. Where are the other mutants? Hello? Hello? Ah. I see. Yes. Those Myalurk hunters or whatever they were that I picked up or aggravated on my way here, they're going to be really useful to help me fight these super mutants. It's a good tip if you weren't aware already that you can sort of lure those Myalurks over here so that come on. I can't aim through that. Give me a clear shot. So that you can get a little bit of extra damage on these guys before, oh, there's still more.
Primary target down. Look at this thing bleed. I'm gonna
find a place to set her down and then hightail it back to the Pridwin for repairs.
Okay. Where is this other guy? Where is he? Can't see him. Oh, there he is. Okay. Oh, there's more. There's more. Oh no, I'm on fire. Wow. There's still more. I should have killed them all. Come on. We can't let him throw another Molotov cocktail at me. I'm surprised that there are actually so many more left. I did not see this many from the air. I thought I had done a pretty good job of getting rid of them. But apparently not. Oh, wow, there's so many. There are so many. Oh, this is not good. Oh, dear. Am I going to be okay? Dance, help me out here, man. No, I don't think that's going to hit. No, you're just wasting action points there. You take over, Dance. You got this. Dance. Ad Victorian, that's the spirit. Okay. Alright, that's a good sign. We have the continuation of the quest. So let me just wander around and make sure we're not missing anything. I don't think there were any legendaries or anything, so it's probably not worth running around and picking up everything. But it might be beneficial to check out the behemoth.
Watch your step. There's quite a bit of debris here.
Yes, I'm concerned about debris. That is my primary concern. Skull faceplate. Oh, that's right, I'm in power armor. Okay, this is gonna chew through my fusion cores really fast. Okay, yeah, I'm gonna have to lay off the vats a little bit. I completely forgot about that. I always do when I hop into power armor. What is this? Why do we have a laser pistol? Yeah, I'm clueless. I don't know. All right, no, forget that.
There must be something significant in this area to merit these fortifications.
Didn't you get briefed on the mission, Dance? You know why we're here. We have a job to do. All right. You know, don't be too put out by my criticism if you're a big Brotherhood of Steel fan. But I do find them to be a little bit distasteful in the way they go about things. And I think it's articulated well enough throughout the game in the opinions of the other NPCs. Describing
a bit of trash to pick through here. Searching through it could prove beneficial.
Describing why the Brotherhood of Steel are basically, you know, articulating what's
so boring.
Articulating what's wrong with
I'd
them.
I'd just
and,
leave that if I were you.
Yeah, well, you're not me, so nah. You hear me? Nah.
Wish a buckethead would show up.
A bucket.
I'd rip his legs clean off. No green stuff here.
Legendary super mutant. It said legendary super mutant. There's a legendary super mutant in there.
Someone there?
I should be a bit more careful then, huh?
Whatever this thing was...
Gonna splatter your grave! Jesus,
hold up. I think we're being stalked.
You think you're being stalked?
Out there! Somewhere!
Dance? Where did Dance go? Is that... Oh! What are you doing up there, Dance? Oh my goodness! I thought you had wandered off down the hallway. Now where are you? He's just teleporting around. Wow. Paladin Danse, you are in my way, and this isn't looking good for you, so could you possibly not do that? Okay, here we go. Let's go for the head. Come on. Come on. Yay!
Gone dark.
Parched from lack of water. That's the least of my problems. Ooh, boy.
Hostiles have retreated.
You know, I'm pretty sure it's gonna be me. We can take bets on it if you like, but... Dance, really? You keep running down there, Dance. I don't know what's wrong with you. Alright. There's nothing up here.
Making a visual on the target.
Dance. Did you do this all by yourself, Dance? This is crazy. I don't like this guy. He's totally messing up my typical style of sneak around. Why am I even sneaking around in power armor? I don't know. I guess my stealth is at a point where I can just sort of sneak around in anything no matter what, and I will not be heard. But, you know... Ooh, what's this?
Word came down that the army just unloaded the first batch of the M42s this morning. I've only seen the specs for these little beauties on paper, so Private Bertram and I snuck down to take an early look. When I heard that the eggheads were designing a man-portable nuke launcher, I thought they were nuts. But they actually got the damn thing to work. And after seeing the real thing sitting right in front of me, I think they could be just enough to tip the balance of this war in our favor. I mean, can you imagine the look on the enemy's face when we get dropped into anchorage carrying these babies? They won't know what hit them.
Yeah, I'm sure. Although, you know, it turns out they used a few more powerful nukes than just the handheld variety. But, you know... These things happen. Okay, so what do we got? We've got... there's nothing else in here. I don't think there is anything too important up here. It's just random junk and stuff. Radio. Oh, okay. Okay. I guess it's not too bad. Assault rifle. Can I carry it? Oh, it's so heavy.
Judging from the amount of dust present,
It's safe to assume we're the first people to investigate this location in quite a while.
What about all the super mutants? What, they don't kick up dust? Come on. Oh, okay. So is that what? Okay, never mind. I was wondering why every time I went up there, Paladin Danse ended up down here. I guess he was sort of like clipping through that ramp or something, but eh. Oh well, we have a pile of bodies now. Look at all these guys. Oh, jeez. Danse, you're a machine. You are just a one-man army. It's crazy. Okay. Okay. Is there anything? Whiskey.
Watch your step. There's quite a bit of debris here.
Yeah, that's fine, man. I'm wearing big metal shoes.